entrepreneurs are, you know, coming forward to do a business. Well, I'm from Bangalore. I've been in Bangalore for a lot of years. I've been born, brought up here. But I've traveled all over the country and worked everywhere else. Let me tell you one thing which is in common everywhere in India. I'll begin with this. Women are very powerful, but we don't know how much powerful we are and how much power we have in us. So here is wishing you a very, very happy International Women's Day. Can we have a round of applause for all of you? Laura said about women entrepreneurship and how to become an entrepreneur, etc. Now, what I'm going to share with you in the next few minutes is practically how do you make yourself a successful woman entrepreneur? Is that fine? I see a lot of students here. I see women between the age group of 20 and 35 here, a lot of you are there who are in this age group. Now, the first thing that you need to do when you want to become an entrepreneur, when the business na shuru maadbekon thagide, what do you need to do? First thing, you have to have an idea. I want to do this, and then think of 10 ideas, don't stick to one idea, and then see what is it that you can do, what is feasible for you, what is it that your heart tells you to do. Sometimes we go and do engineering or we study some course which our parents want us to do. When you do something like that, your heart really is not there, you know. So when you start a business, start something which you really want to do, which where your heart lies. Next thing that you need to do is you need to empower yourself and equip yourself with knowledge of that particular business or that particular product. So if you are into painting, if you think that you know one kind of painting, then you should probably learn the other arts also, right? So you have to become a person who knows different ways or different styles of painting, but you can master one. Okay? So if you want to start a beauty salon, for example, you need to understand everything there is to understand about the beauty salon. From how do you, what is pedicure and how do you do a pedicure, to how do you do different hairstyles, to how to actually do eyebrows, etc. You need to know that first. You may not be doing it on a daily basis, but you need to know so that you are the master. Then you can tell your people and you who are experts, whether they are, you can guide them. You can understand the customer's point of view. So equipping yourself with knowledge related to that business is very, very important. Third, this is the most important thing when you start a business, when you become a woman entrepreneur, or any entrepreneur, even for men, is how do you brand yourself? One is branding your product. The second is, how do you do your personal branding? What is personal branding? Anybody knows? What is personal branding? Okay. What do you think of someone like when I say Aishwarya Rai? Miss what? Beautiful? Then you think of her as a successful actress, now a mother, a brand ambassador for L'Oreal and many other products, right? So everybody has something called a personal brand. You have to create that personal brand. That is what will help you to sell yourselves. What is personal brand? One is look at the way you're presenting yourself to the world. That is called image. Now I'm going to talk a little bit about what is image. Image means the way other people see you, the way you see yourself, and the way other people perceive you. Okay? So once people see you, they think of something about you, right? Oh, this person is probably so and so. This person comes across as a very confident person. This person is not so confident. And oh, I like the way this person has worn clothes or appearance, for example. So people are understanding about you. There is one saying which I totally believe in. Success begets success. If you are successful, you will become more successful. If you are confident, you will become more confident. Why? Because if I'm able to stand here and talk, and if you guys like it, then I get more confidence that I can stand and talk to a larger audience than this another way. Are you getting me? So it is important for you to understand, to project yourself as successful. To do that, you should feel good about yourself. Number one, if you think, oh, I can't do this, you know, if you think of yourself like that, you're putting yourself down. Go and try to, you know, look and feel confident. Okay? One is the way you project yourself, which is your image, which is very, very important. Two is your communication skills. If you do not know a certain language and you feel that it is important for you to speak in that language somewhere, go learn it. You can learn it from different avenues, you can learn it from the internet, you can learn it from just speaking and making mistakes. Communication is very important. What do you think and what do you say can be two different things. So learn how to communicate properly. Third is your body language, okay? The way you stand, the way you talk, okay? Somebody who's standing and talking like, will you listen to them? No. Somebody who's talking like this, will you listen to them? Somebody is going to give you an order. No, if I'm standing like this, I look like I'm going to give you an order. Right? So somebody who's confident is what people will listen to. So if you have started your business, your body language, your communication style should be very, very appropriate for your business. Right? And again, think of customers. What do customers want? All customers want something. They can be different things, but all customers do want something. If you are a customer, you're going to a restaurant, what do you want? If you are a customer, if you're going to a shop, what do you want? You want somebody to stand there, understand you and give you products in the way you want it. Okay? So think of what your customers want and try and give that to them if you want to prosper. The next thing which I'm going to tell you is about empowering yourself. We're talking about women empowerment. But what is empowerment? When you actually get into business and you're standing there or sitting there in your stall or you have a running business like your ma'am has and you have ma'am. What do you exactly need? You need to keep topping up your knowledge skills. World is going fast. How many of you change your phones every 3 months, 4 months, 6 months, maybe 1 year because you got bored? Please put your hands up. I can see a lot of heads nodding. We all do it. We don't say that. But we all do it. How many of you look for new fashion styles? Colors, cuts. How many of you go to your tailor and say, I want a blouse today stitched like this with this pattern here? We all do that? Then if you want new things, people also want new things from you, know? World is moving very fast. How many of you have seen 6-year-old, 7-year-old children getting more comfortable with your mobile phones than you? Kids are more comfortable with the internet, more comfortable with mobile phones than we are. Correct? Yes or no? So, world is moving really fast. Now, if you are a BCom student, you did your BCom in 2000 or 2005, okay, or 2010, and you're saying, aha, I'm a graduate, I don't need to do anything more. Boss, your customers are moving very fast. They want the world from you. You have done your BCom in 2010, but 2014, what have you done? So it is time for you to empower yourself with more and more and more knowledge and more certificates, more degrees, etc. From time to time to time, you need to keep empowering yourself with more knowledge. That is going to give you success. Think about your competitors. What are they doing? If they are doing something else, you better be 2 steps ahead of them. If you are into business and if you are a small scale industrialist here, if you have a small scale business, then you better know your business very well. You should be very, very confident that you are on top of your business. These things put together will give you success. also. I have a lot of individual one-to-one clients who, you know, also I work with. Many people give up their jobs after, you know, childbirth or when they get married. They give their jobs up and they want a more, something more comfortable which they can do from their home. There are a lot of opportunities, a lot of programs that you can attend and you can get certified. And then you can start your own business from your house. And I'm doing it right now. I'm doing something like that. Well, I had a very, very successful corporate career. I quit my job thinking now I'm done with my corporate career and I want to do something on my own. I came across an ad in the newspaper and I had my friends also telling me this is called the Image Consulting Business Institute, okay, which basically is nothing but an institute which offers courses on image management. Okay, this course is open for anybody and everybody. If you want to become an image consultant or a fashion stylist or a soft skill trainer or a trainer by yourself, you can attend several courses in this institute and then you can become a certified either image consultant or a trainer. So this is also an opportunity that you have. You can become your own boss. You have your own business as an image consultant or a trainer. Right? So the few things that I have told you today, one is how do you keep your image strong and confident? Two is what should you do to start a business? One is you need to identify what you want to do. You should love that particular subject or the business that you're taking up. Then you need to understand what you need to do that business. Then you need to empower yourself. You need to learn, do a course or something like that so that you are master of your business. And then you need to approach your customers the way they want you to approach them. Right? Thank you very much for this opportunity and have fun speaking.